Hello and welcome to the Exodus channel, your home for the best crypto videos. Hit those like and subscribe buttons and we will keep the videos coming. People are calling Web3 the next revolution of the internet, but what is Web3? Well, to understand Web3, let's first understand Web1 and Web2. Web1 is the internet of the 90s, a simple internet of pages that hosted lots of information. Internet users could browse these pages, but not really interact with them. People could send emails back and forth, but the communication was primarily one way. Then came Web2, which brought us a more interactive internet and a two-way communication style. This is the internet as we know today. Social media sites like YouTube and Facebook and mobile apps have actually allowed internet users to interact with information and other people in more meaningful ways. Web3 is based on two key fundamental changes that it's making to the internet. Number one, the ability to own something digitally without the need of a custodian or third party like Facebook. And number two, interoperability across platforms. Let's start with digital ownership. If we buy a shirt in a store in the real world, we can wear it anywhere and do as we please with it. We don't have to take it off when we leave the place where we bought it. We actually own it. In Web2, however, if we buy something in a game, it stays in that one closed environment. If you're familiar with buying skins in games like Fortnite, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. The skin remains in the game. Wouldn't it be cool if you could take that outfit or helmet or gun with you across to other digital worlds, or even sell it in a marketplace outside of Fortnite? That would feel like you really own the skin you paid for. This is true digital ownership. And this leads us back to number two, interoperability across platforms. Right now, I have one account for Instagram and another one for TikTok, and yet another for my bank. My information remains within the hands of those platforms. It doesn't cross over. My data remains siloed and under the control and ownership of the hosting platform. Web3 enables the potential for your web browser or crypto wallet to become your one secure account across the entire internet. It enables hosting and security of your personal data. This means that things like your money, possessions, and ID will move in and out of applications with you. No more having to open a bunch of accounts and remember dozens of passwords.
Passwords. Everything's got a password. Any company you call, you've got to have a password. It's so hackers can't get into your bank account. Yeah, well, neither can I.
Applications can, for example, already confirm your blockchain security identity without even having to see it. Web3's ability to work across platforms is because of its programmability. Developers are creating specific digital experiences, providing access to private areas, and showing custom-made content, all based on what tokens the user has in their wallet. So one single token can be a form of equity and your access into a Discord community and your ticket to an exclusive real-life event all at the same time. As Web3 development advances, this will result in a massive unlock for innovation and capital flow around the world. You may have seen recently that Microsoft contributed to a fundraising round from Consensus, the company that developed Ethereum's MetaMask web browser. MetaMask can be used to interact with many dApps that are built on Ethereum, but imagine a multi-blockchain future where your browser extension has the functionality across the entire internet, not just crypto apps. Thanks for watching, everyone. We've got a lot more videos for you, so click any of these videos so you can keep watching. And don't forget to like if you liked it and sub if you dug it.